chance. Choice though, actually, tell the truth now. Yeah, looks like we're going through the forest, guys. One thing I wouldn't mind is a bit of this. I wouldn't mind some saplings of these dark oak, aren't they? Yeah, dark oak. Let's try and get at least a sapling or two. looks like it's beginning to get a little bit dark, so we'll just post up. That's east this way, where the sun rises in the east. The east being Asia, and it's called the land of the rising sun. This very easy way. It's not too bad. Kind of want to go up here, don't we? I think. There's wolves there. Size of a sheep sometimes. Although I did see a picture actually of a rabbit which was absolutely huge. It was about the size of a medium sized dog. It was called Atlas, I think, and they were looking for a home for it because their owner could no longer look after the rabbit for obvious reasons, the fact that it was huge being one of them. But so they were looking for a home for the rabbit. I think I'd feel very weird looking after a rabbit that big, because it literally did look like it could kind of eat you. Kind of like having a small bear as a pet. Upgraded because it's like a kind of hour and a half spectacular, and even with kind of condensing the file size, it's ginormous and would take me like 2 days to upload. And I think I've spoken about this before, where my upload speed's so bad that not only does it take days and days, but also my internet for anything else while it's uploading, it just won't run. So generally what I do is actually I upload overnight, then do all the kind of finicky bits in the morning, and then put it to go live in the afternoon. File was like 20, so because it's a really good story, and actually everything kind of comes together and you learn a lot of stuff. So I kind of wanted to leave the whole thing up, but depending on what happens with my internet, I may have to cut it into two or even possibly three parts. Look at the size of this pine forest. Okay, we are still heading east. So now I can start the Thieves Guild questline, but I'll actually probably just give it a little bit of a break. Just, you know, maybe a month or two, maybe a month, 6 weeks, something like that. Just to kind of mix up a little bit. Same old, and those wonderful hill structures. You know, all I ask for is a jungle biome. What are we in at the minute? Well, ocean, yeah, obviously, sorry. That was a dumb question. What's over here? It's like a plainsy biome. Procedure generates the land. It's really fascinating, actually. Just looking at it as it pops up. I wonder if that's it kind of building it there, or if it kind of knows what it's going to be doing for a set distance, and then it's just it kind of graphically loading, or if when it loads in like that with this new bits of land, that it is kind of procedure generating it as it goes. We will step off here, so I'm going to need to eat the bread. Now, if we don't find the food, worst comes to the worst, we could kill an animal. Don't particularly want to. So far in this entire playthrough, I've only killed one animal. Well, that's a lie. On camera, I've only killed one animal. To get the leather for the item frames, workshop, I killed a few more, but I'm sustainably farming them at the minute, so that's okay. You know, it's just a shame. The only way to get leather from a cow is to kill it, because you can get pretty much any, well, that's a lie actually. Again, you can't get you can get wool from sheep, but can't get slime from slime balls from slimes without killing them. You can't get magma set up for the night. Let's go over here, I guess. Or down here, there we go, it's nice and flat here. East, that's south, that's east this way, okay. Once again, I should be able to tell that by the sun, but what can I say? I love the look of the sun as it just kind of raises up over those trees there, it just looks stunning, doesn't it? Reminds me of The Witcher 3. A game I really need to get back into. It's incredible actually, if you probably said to me, what are your kind of two of your favourite games from last year? I would say two of them would easily be The Witcher 3 and Metal Gear Solid 5. Brilliant games, and I think I've told this story before, but I was very, very close to, wait, can you hear a slime? Hold that thought, is it down here or? It's down here, oh my god, look how scary that is. What the hell is that? That's mental. Gave me loads of slime balls though, didn't it? Wicked. Okay, great. Now we can build a lead. Can't build a saddle, of course. Gonna have to find one of them, but at least we could tie up a horse ready for the saddle. That face on that slime ball, that will stay with me for years. Oh my god, if I ever see one of them again, it would be too soon. What is that about? Who the hell made this mod pack? Or this resource pack, I should say. What the hell were they thinking? Wow. God. Anybody watches Doctor Who? That genuinely looks like the face of Bo there. Maybe that's what they were going for, I don't know. But anyway, I think I was saying that if you were to ask me two of my favourite games, Witcher 3, Metal Gear Solid 5, Witcher 3, I've put a lot of hours into. I need to get back into it again because I played through it, nearly completed it, and then my computer kind of had a massive failure and I had to wipe my hard drive, and I thought it would cloud save, but apparently on GOG, GOG Galaxy, it doesn't. At least you have to select that it does, whereas on Steam it just does. So completely my fault, but I wiped my save like 80 something hours in the game, and I wiped my save. Oh, we're in the water. I was just checking which way we were going. Yep, still getting east, good. So that was very sad, and then I started it again, but I've never been one to kind of play through a game more than once, unless it's something like a Skyrim or something like that, which I know Witcher 3 does sound like it's very similar to Skyrim, but it isn't, and the reason it isn't is because you, when I play Skyrim, I usually play through the first time kind of normally, or, you know, kind of Fallout 4, I did the same thing, play out normally, kind of experience it, and then I'll do something different, like I'll have a completely different character build, you know, instead of using guns or something, or instead of using a bow and Skyrim, I'll go swords, something like that. So the whole kind of gameplay shifts, whereas in The Witcher, you're always going to be using a sword. You're always going to be, you know, using the signs. You could say you could concentrate on the kind of signs instead of swords and stuff like that. But, and by the way, this isn't a criticism of the game. Oh, dear. Whoops. It's just, the reason for me why I am struggling to play through it a second time. So I really would like to get back into it again and get going on it, because the expansions are coming out. Well, I haven't played the first expansion obviously yet, and the second expansion is coming towards the end of this year, and apparently that's pretty huge. So I'd really love to get going on that. But I have this kind of thing where it's always been the same, where I can't watch a film like more than once. It's very rare for me to watch a film more than once, or read a book more than once, because I know what happens. So I just find I can't read it more than once, whereas I know, wow, that's a deep water. I did not expect that. That's really deep. Wow. You can kind of just about see the bottom there. Should have got a boat. But yeah, so for me, I find it difficult in games to kind of play, especially like story games, more story driven games, which kind of Witcher's current, they are story driven games. Obviously, you know, things like The Binding of Isaac is not really much of an issue playing that game more than once. A voice to begin with, but the voice grew on me a lot and I ended up really liking it. Reminds me a lot actually of Tracer from Overwatch. But anyway, going off on a tangent again, so Witcher 3 and Metal Gear Solid 5. Now Metal Gear Solid 5 is a weird one because I adore that game. It's so much fun, but I don't really have a burning passion to complete it. Like, it's weird. I've only put maybe 50 hours into it, but I would say that it's one of my favourite games of all time, because those 50 hours were incredible. And yet, for some reason, I haven't gone back and touched it for months now. And I don't really know why. And I really need to get back into it, actually. I'd never played a Metal Gear game before it, but I don't think you really necessarily need to, for story-wise. Oh, there's another village over there, we'll go have a look. Wow, okay, cool. It's a different type of village as well. That's cool, actually. That's a great way to end this episode, actually. So I don't know why, but I really, really love the game. I love the way it looks. I love the way it plays. Just the detail in it is incredible. The soundtrack, everything is incredible about it. It's a masterpiece, but in every way. You know, the only way you can like that game is if you're just not a fan of the genre. You know? But for what it is, it's one of the greatest. greatest games that's ever existed. But again, I think because it's quite linear, if that makes sense. So there are different ways you can play the game. Obviously, there are lots of choices. It's not a criticism of it in any way, but I think I prefer games where it's kind of choose your own adventure. That's the replayability for me. I've never been one who's into all this tweet. I've never been into kind of getting every collectible and things like that. Who are these guys? They're Mr. Butcher. Certainly enjoyed making it so far. Been a nice adventure, but I